Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. If you've ever used QTableView, I'll bet you that you've had your problems with it. In this episode, I will solve all problems you've ever had with QTableView. Okay, not all problems, but hopefully you'll be slightly enlightened when it comes to how does the columns stretch? How do you make the table actually take up just enough space so it can show all the content? How do you, well, all of those things. Let's dive into them one at a time. So what you're looking at here is a very simple application. It creates a table view and a text edit just so that it can go into a layout, which it does here. Then I'm creating a simple model with 10 rows and 5 columns, and I am giving that model to the view. I am at the end showing it all, and as you can see in between here, lots of different small tests. But let's start out running the default setup. That's with all of those saying false. And this is what your application will very likely look like. A table view up here, sitting in a layout. For some reason, it was sitting next to it to a Qt text edit, and they got to share the size. So what you're looking at here is a lot of empty space. Super annoying to waste your screen real estate like this, especially if column number 5 could have taken some extra space, or column number 3 for that matter. It could be a string that you needed to input, and the more space you had, the better. So how do you fix all of those things? Well, let's take them one at a time. But before we do that, what is exactly sitting here? Let's try and figure that out. The easiest way to do that is to use Gammaray. So I'll just go to my external KDAB, start in Gammaray. And here's my application running again, this time in Gammaray. And Control Shift click will tell me exactly under that position of the cursor what is there. And as you can see here, this whole thing that we have here, that's actually, as you can see over here, Qt_scroll_area_viewport. So that's the viewport. That is where we are rendering the table onto. That is where the paint event of the Qt abstracts, whatever it's called, scroll area, I think, that is where it is actually rendering the pixels. You can see up here, if I control shift click, that's the whole, That's the whole table view that I have there. But it's my viewport that is sitting here, and it's not being utilized by the Qt table view itself. So the mission that I set out for us now is, can I stretch the different columns so that they work perfectly? First of all, let's see what it looked like all the way back to Qt 4 days. We still have that API around, and in your legacy code, you might find a lot of that. So what you can see now is that my last column here has been stretched, and the last row has been stretched. And I do so with code that looks like this. Horizontal header, that's the thing that we have sitting up here at the top. Set stretch last section, meaning the last section, that's column number 5, stretch that one. So when I resize my window, you can see that it takes up the additional space. If I resize it more lower than a given certain threshold, it will just put scroll bars on it. I get to my horizontal header by simply going to the view and asking for its horizontal header. And I can get to the vertical header. That's the one we've sitting down here. I can get to that too. And I can also call set stretch last section true, which will make the last row take up additional space. Usually you don't want to do that, but you can do that. This was all Qt 4 API. So in the Qt 4 days, I was about to say it would be impossible, but nothing is impossible, but it would definitely be very hard to stretch other columns in there. So in Qt 5, we got a bit of new API where we can do that. So let's see what that looks like. So what it looks like now is that I, on my horizontal header again, and of course on my vertical header, but let's just focus on the horizontal one now. We can say set section resize, and then the section. So this is section 0, this is section 1, 2, and so on. And for 1 and 2, I say stretch. So you can see if I resize these two, so column 1, meaning the one with header 2, and column 2, they get all the additional space. And also I say set section resize for 3, they're resized to content. You can see it fits exactly the content we have here. Now, if I've used any of those two, I cannot resize the section anymore. See, no resize handler, because it'll always stretch. No resize handler here, no resize handler here. Actually, there's a resize handler down here, which makes it really weird UI, because when I start resizing it, well, I can't because I'm at the edge of the screen. When I start resizing it, you can see it will get more space, and that's on behalf of these. And this one, of course, works similarly. Yeah, you just laugh at me for not being able to say that word. In Q5, we were setting for each of the column how it should be stretching. We can also say it on all of the columns, so without the one comma, we could do that, just set it to stretch all of them to the content. And I'll show you how to do that, but get ready for seeing the hallelujah moment of this video here when I do the same thing for rows. So all I need to do is, instead of saying it for set section resize mode 1, 2, and 3 and whatever, I can simply say set section resize mode, everything should be resizing to the size here. Let me now do the same thing for the rows, something that I don't understand why it's not the default. Maybe it's to be compatible. Observe that my rows now are much slimmer. They are resized to the content rather than having that enormous additional space. I have seen lots of people over the year abusing a QTableView to show what is really a table, because the tree view is much more condensed. But with this line down here, that is game over. Vertical header. So the vertical header down here, set section resize mode, resize to content. That is the default in all of the tables that I have from now on. It makes them so much more compressed and therefore, at least for my taste, more beautiful. Yes, but wait, stop. You were ahead of me there. Can we just scroll back, pun intended, to what you said there about you cannot resize those that you told to a size to the content of the column. But I really want to do that. I want my columns to have a good, reasonable initial size, but then the user, if they for some reason want more size, they should be able to resize it. Is that impossible? And the answer, of course, is no. So what you can see now is that I can actually, they all initialize to a good size here, but if I resize them, I can do that. All I need to do is to call a bit different API. Up here, I said that I want the section resize mode, meaning all the time, follow this rule here. Now I just want to say on the view, this was on the vertical header, on the view, I just say resize the column to content. Why is it on the view and not on the header? I don't know. An oversight possibly in the API design. But anyway, what I do here is I simply run through all the columns and I resize them to the content. I say to the last one, please do resize or take additional space, just because I hate that white space at the end there. And that's it. There's one more line here. Horizontal header, set resize content precision. Let me show you what that's all about. For doing that, I need to go up here and I need to find the line where I create my elements. So let's say, where is that? There we are. C++ 17 for specifying. I want 100,000 rows. And actually, I need to go down and not have that line because that's what I'm trying to show you. So here it is again, and you can see scrolling all the way down to the bottom, it still looks good. I've used the size of 9999993, so that's the size of my cell. But if I didn't have that one, if I didn't have this one line here saying set resize content precision, then what you'll see is that my rows will be smaller. And if I scroll down, you can see, ooh. And the reason for that is that Qt will not waste a lot of CPU on your behalf for going through all 10 or all 100,000 rows to find out how wide they are. especially if the model underneath is a complex one, that makes a lot of sense. But if you know, hey, it's super fast for me anyway, and I really prefer to have it look correct all the way down to the bottom rather than be fast, then you will re-add this line here saying horizontal header set resize content precision -1. Otherwise, it's a number, and you can say, okay, let's go for the first 10,000. In the first 10,000 rows, I'm sure I've seen the variation, so that should be good enough for me. So the final question I'd like to answer in this episode here on QTableView Galore is, how can I make my table view take exactly the amount of size that it needs to show all the content without adding those pesky scroll bars? And there's API for that too. Let me show you. So now I created a small timer here that every 2 seconds add a new row, and you can see that the size of my table actually grows. It will ask the layout that it's in to get more space, at least until the time where it absolutely cannot get more space without jeopardizing somebody else's minimum size hint. And the API for this is simply on the view again, called set size adjust policy. And what it says is, what will the table view itself do to its size whenever the viewport content that it's showing is resizing? And well, it has a few different options. The default is just don't do anything. Then there is the option of saying, well, adjust on the very first show. And then there's this adjust to content, which means every time we get more data, adjust the data. And as you can see here again, I get row 11, 12, and now you can see that it start adjusting and pushing the Q text edit underneath down so that it can take the additional space. So that's it for this episode here. I know it was to a large extent just walking over the API, but somehow it is difficult to think of looking at the Q header view for the API that you need when you're sitting there with a Q table. And next time you got one of these problems, remember this video. Maybe you should bookmark it so that next time you need the table to be exactly the size that it needs, or you need a column to be resizable, but start out with the initial size, then you know where to go. I'm Jesper Petersen from KDAB. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do leave your comments below with your thoughts, your everything, and remember that thumbs up. It just gives me a thrill every time I see a new thumb up and a comment saying, hey Jesper, what a perfect haircut you have there. Never mind. Until next time, enjoy life and have a great time.